Hello, St. Louis Park. Welcome to the Parktacular Parade.
Hello.
My name is Beth Johnson.
And I'm Paul Carver.
And we have a third helper who is working across the street. We'll have her introduce herself in a little bit. We are at the parade route, and we are watching the parade coming down the hill.
Such a great suggestion.
And our trio is complete. We are all here. Welcome to today's parade. We've got beautiful weather for us. I think you're going to get to see us. Here we are.
Hey, everyone.
Welcome, welcome. If you're not out here, you're probably cool. So that's okay. We've got some great weather for you.
The sun came out just in time to welcome everybody here to the parade today.
It did indeed. It's a nice 76, which
Ooh, is it really?
It is. Absolutely.
Nice. That's comfortable.
Yeah, we're good. All right, the kids are lined up. I see some treat bags.
They are
all ready. I don't know what
ready.
More we need. We do have a former princess with us who, when we have a lull, is going to teach the children across on the technique of parade waves.
Yes, Winter Carnival School of Parade Waving.
If you were thinking about this is not exciting enough and you're going to change channels, I think that... Stay tuned.
It's riveting. It's
yeah.
riveting.
We took the training, actually. Beth and I took the training before.
We did.
And I got to say, my wave is so much better now.
Yeah. You're more confident in the wave.
Yeah. I am. Yeah. Yeah. Wash the window.
Exactly.
Yes,
exactly.
Absolutely.
I think the pearls thing was my favorite.
I'm so glad you've given everybody a teaser.
Oh, the microwave. That really.
You're right.
That was good, too. That was good, too. All right. It looks like we've got some folks in view here. It is the Parktacular Grand Day Parade. We have had the Parktacular running for many, many years, and this is such a nice spot for us. It does end at Wolf Park. If you're in St. Louis Park today and you're looking for something to do, please come on down. There are so many activities going on. There's all kinds of our wonderful organizations down there, and dare I say, a wee bit of food.
A wee bit of food. Oh, I can't wait for that.
It's good, it's good, it's good.
We can smell it all the way up here. It's just, smells delicious.
It really does. I'm getting hungry.
Well, the parade has just begun, so I guess we're gonna be distracted from our hunger by the wonderful parade, and then we will feast after.
We can do that. First up.
Oh, it's wonderful. The Fire Department Honor Guard is an 8-member unit that has formed. It was formed in 2015 to honor those who serve our community as firefighters and EMS professionals. The Honor Guard members regularly train and prepare for fire service ceremonial duties. The group is led by team leader Adam Lochran. And marching today is Adam Lochran, Susan Roy, and Dan Erzberger.
All right. And this probably won't be too much of a surprise. This will be the St. Louis Park Fire Department. They are proud to be celebrating 100 years of service to the city. Leading the parade was the first motorized pumper of the fire department. It's a 1928 American La France, for those of you who are buffs on that. It served as our fire engine for over 40 years and is the oldest one in the department. Quint 2 is the newest vehicle. Hello, hello. That was purchased new in 2016. There you go. And it has a 78-foot ladder, a 1,500 gallons per minute pump, and as you can tell, a really nice horn.
Woo!
We also got to see Sparky the dog there, a member of the fire department.
We love Sparky. What a good guy.
There's engine number 2.
Dang,
bright
that's
and
really
shiny.
Cool. What's the symbolism of Quint? Who's Quint? Does 5?
Oh.
Sprays water. Hose. Ladder on top. Rescue and ground.
Oh, very cool.
Excellent. Good job. You pass.
So we just learned something there, too.
Nice.
That's fantastic.
Quint stands for something. Huh.
Coming up next is the Hennepin County Sheriff's Office. Utilized unpaid volunteer special deputies to assist with daily operations. There are over 100 volunteers who have dedicated over 28,000 hours to the Sheriff's Office over the last year.
And they have some beautiful horses.
Beautiful horses.
Oh my goodness.
Hard-working horses.
Good morning. Or afternoon, isn't it? Sorry. Nice.
And next up, we have the Frank Ludenberg American Legion Post 282 Color Guard. And the post was founded in 1919. Oh,
where?
I'm sorry. Not quite yet. We still have the Sheriff's Department. We're still enjoying the Sheriff's Department.
Or?
Yeah, so we've actually got a boat coming down the road right now. That's something else.
See, where can you go but the Parktacular Parade to see a boat on the road?
Absolutely.
Come on. Lake Minnetonka's got nothing on us.
So that would be one of the rescue boats or boats that they use to patrol out on the water.
Very cool.
All different facets of the Sheriff's Department.
Wow. Nice boat.
Thank you.
Hi. Thank you. And now we get to stand
there.
Up and cheer for our veterans. Now is the Frank Ludenberg American Legion Post 282 Color
Good
Guard.
Job. And in case you can't hear it, they're getting applause everywhere
Hooray.
They go.
Thank you. Thank you for your service.
As well as the Boy Scouts of Troop 225. Oh,
and I see a familiar face there. There's Mr. Jim Rhodes.
Yes, it is indeed.
Hey,
hey Jim. Good to see you.
Of course, this whole unit includes veterans who have served in several wars and conflicts.
Here we have a nice truck from the United States Marine Corps.
Mm-hmm.
Nice. We got some young folks sitting in the back there as well with their flags.
Yeah, he says, I don't want to wave at you. All right, that's fine.
Don't take it personally.
No, I never do. I should probably, but I don't. Okay.
And I think we're on to Boy Scouts.
Oh my goodness, look at this. This is B-Boy Scout Troop 307 and 205. And they're walking with the American Legion Post 282. Oh my gosh, look at that.
They have bottles of water, which I could use one of
man.
Them right now.
So smart, so smart.
Nice.
Hey there.
And some candy. That's a good way to go.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I got some taffy here.
Hooray!
Flags.
Awesome.
Perfect.
Thanks.
Thank you so much.
Beautiful.
This is a smart man right here.
He is. He's bringing
nice.
The water over. Thank you very
thank
much.
Thank you so much. I'm good. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right.
That's a good
and,
way to do it.
They are being followed by a truck that is much newer than the one that's talked about here on my script. So I'm just going to wing this one.
This is still the Boy Scouts. This is the other troop.
Good,
no, thank you, but thank you very much.
Yep, and they're advertising the Father's Day Waffle Breakfast, which is Sunday, June 19th. And
tomorrow.
That's at the St. Louis Park Rec Center Banquet Room
so
from 9 a.m. to 1.
Family's not sure yet what they're doing for Father's Day. We've got it. We've got you covered.
Now, I really like this. This is the Mini that we've got coming up here. I'm not sure who's in that car. It looks like maybe Sue Sanger. Excuse me.
Sue's there. The mayor is right here. Want to interview
yes,
the mayor.
Yes, absolutely.
And
then
some
we have
city council members there.
The mayor is walking today, St. Louis Park Mayor Jake Spano. And right behind him in the Mini.
You guys are doing such a great job.
Yes, we
Thank
are.
Thank you.
Yes,
so
are
you.
Thank you.
We've got current council member.
Hey, Sue.
Good to see you. The current city council consists of at-large members Steve Halfin, Tom Miller, and ward council member Sue Sanger from Ward 1 and Mavity. Ward 2, Greg Lindberg, Ward 3, and Tim Brownson, Ward 4. Former at-large council member Jake Spano took over as the new mayor in January of 2016.
And Paul is new addition to our group here, and he had to memorize that in order for him to join us.
I did,
announcing
yes.
today, so that was really good. You passed.
Thank you.
Good
yeah, job. I was up late last night yeah. preparing.
See, it was worth it.
It was.
It was
coming
so worth
right
it.
Up.
That was amazing.
Coming right up, we have the Parktacular Festival is proud to introduce the St. Louis Park Ambassadors. St. Louis Park is the birthplace of the Children's First Initiative, and these ambassadors spend the year at parades, coronations, and community functions promoting the 40 developmental assets and the Parktacular celebration. The ambassadors have received numerous awards from Aquatennial, Winter Carnival, Hopkins Raspberry Festival, Warrens, Wisconsin, and North Hudson Pepper Fest. On the float, we have Ambassadors Maris and Kanaya.
And let me interrupt you for just 1 minute. We might have one really very, very, very hard worker who I do believe turned 50 today.
Next week.
Is turning next 50 week. Next week.
Tammy so, McKenna.
Tammy McKenna. This is what 50 looks like.
Thank you.
You go, girl.
Thank you.
We always want to make sure
looking
we
good.
Acknowledge our senior ambassadors, Greg and Jackie, and our junior ambassadors, Aiden, Abigail, Sarah, and Avia.
And here is Discover St. Louis Park. How beautiful is that?
Their goal is to strengthen the awareness of St. Louis Park as well as serve as a prime meeting and visitor destination. They want to stimulate economic growth and support community support. Support community growth. And they want you to use them as your one-stop shop resource for SLP dining, shopping, and entertainment.
They really are a wonderful resource.
They're doing a great job, too. This just the business here has really grown.
Yes.
People are coming to our community
yes.
because of them.
It's really wonderful. Next up is the Salvation Army Engineers Disaster Service. They respond to all official requests for assistance, fires, natural disasters, police standoffs, or any other long-term emergencies. Looks like they are well equipped, very cool.
They do some wonderful work, but they couldn't do it without donations. So there's somebody to always keep in mind, especially when there is a disaster somewhere.
True, true, true.
Whoa, and here come the clowns.
Woo-hoo.
It's the Aqua Jesters. Hey. They've been entertaining kids and adults alike for 69 years.
She's walking a skunk.
Laughter must enhance longevity, and they don't look that old. Well, that one does, but
yeah,
most of them don't.
Okay.
This is an all-volunteer club consisting of men and women of all ages who make appearances at parades, hospitals, nonprofit events throughout the year. And they're always looking for new recruits. How about it, guys? You want to sign up to be clowns?
Well, no. I don't think my legs would fit in that little car.
We could get
on,
a stretch for you.
Yeah, there you go. I need a longer car. That is pretty funny, though. Look at that one.
Oh, it's fantastic.
Oh, and here comes a little red fire truck with the Dalmatian on the front. Oh, I love it.
More clowning around.
Good one.
See, you're looks... already ready to be part of the group.
That one looks even older than the St. Louis Park fire truck.
It does, indeed.
The Aqua Jesters. Fantastic.
That's fun.
Who do we have here?
Next on the lineup, we have Park Valley Football Club. This is a local youth soccer club for boys and girls ages 5 to 18. And there are recreational as well as competitive levels. They serve St. Louis Park, Golden Valley, and the surrounding area. I bet they can show off some pretty fancy footwork.
Yeah, there's a couple of them doing that right now. And this is the real football, the one where you actually use your feet.
Woo!
Yeah. Yeah, come on, show us your stuff.
Show us your stuff.
Oh,
yes.
Okay. You did a rainbow.
It was
good
awesome.
Job.
Learned a new term.
Good job. And they're waving at the camera.
Now they've got a classic Buick here, a GS. Good looking car.
And as you know, the ambassador program is a very, very important part of Parktacular. Our first ambassador candidate is coming along. I do believe this is Angela.
It is.
Angela will be a senior at St. Louis Park this fall. When she graduates, she'd like to work at St. Jude's. Excellent. She wants to become an ambassador so she can promote her community and the great education system. And she's being driven by Bill Imhoffer, I do believe.
In a beautiful Corvette.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, what fun.
All right, I think that's a 1979.
Good for you.
Who's there to correct me?
Nobody. No one.
So
you're
going.
Right.
It sounds great to me.
Oh, we had a 78, so there you go. All right, our next ambassador candidate is Kim. She graduated a few weeks ago from St. Louis Park. She plans to attend the U of M in the fall. She's active with the robotics team and enjoys painting. How cool is that? And she's being driven by Patty Sue Imhoffer. And we wish them both luck. I do believe the coronation is this afternoon at 4 o'clock.
Yes, it is, at the high school.
Oh, that's wonderful. We've got a little bit of a break here. I think maybe this would be a really good time for you to do a quick lesson. Come on.
All right.
Come on.
Game on.
All right.
All right, folks, I'm going to need your assistance here.
This is called the Winter Carnival School of Parade Waving, and I need your participation. Are you ready?
All right. Work out those arms. Stretch it out.
Okay, go for it.
I need you to put one arm up in the air, probably your right arm. We're going to wash the windows. Switch arms. Wash the windows. Missed a spot. You'll learn a new one. Okay, we got some classics. The microwave. It's very tiny. It's the microwave.
Excellent.
Very small. And a very classic, change the light bulb. Well done, folks. You guys are ready for a parade.
All right.
Very good. I'm getting even better.
Good job.
Nicely done. You guys got it down.
All right, it's
You're
the Blaine High School.
What they've learned.
Blaine High School, let's take a listen.
That was fun.
Marching Bengals. They're from Blaine High School. Got a couple proud parents in the audience here. They're proud to present their 2016 production, Once Upon a Dream. There we go. To a certain clarinet player, because there's one dad here that said she's the best.
Fantastic.
So I'm just saying.
And you just have to, you don't just appreciate the talent, but you also appreciate the aerobic workout they're getting.
Oh, indeed. Especially on a day like this, wearing those uniforms.
In this group, the Bengals compete around the state. They've won numerous awards for winds, percussion, and color guard, as you can obviously tell.
Yeah.
2015, they traveled to Orlando and marched in the Disney Magic Parade. Oh, how much fun would that be?
Blast.
Oh, my goodness. Love it, love it, love it. I believe that might be the only marching band we've got today, so they did us proud. More royalty.
And right now we have the city of Columbia Heights. Some of their royalty are able to join us today. Some of their group is representing their city in Red Rock, Colorado. So we're so pleased you're able to join us today. Wish your fellow ambassadors good luck in Colorado.
Thank you for that, yes. Now, what do we have coming up next? It's called Seeds Has Enveloped Offers, free or low cost, hands-on wellness workshops surrounding food while incorporating activity and mental well-being, along with community building, while growing young farmers in the park, playground, and schools. Seeds Has Planted Change.
Oh, very cool.
Join them at Kidtacular and pick up a salad basket or plants or a free packet of seeds or feed some worms.
It looks like
how about
safe,
that?
Edible, earth, diverse service.
It looks wonderful. Very good.
Oh, very cool.
Clever name.
That's very cool. Somebody should tell her, though, she's got a bunch of plants in the back of her truck.
Well, we have our first particular junior ambassador candidates. We have Vanessa and Vladimir. Vanessa is a third grader at Peter Hobart School, and Vladimir attends Aquila School. Their favorite teachers are Ms. Martinson and Mrs. Rooney.
Aww.
And we want to wish them good luck today at coronation.
We got some cowboys.
Okay, the Zura Horse Patrol. Oh man, I love those guys. They were formed in 1947 as a unit of the Zura Shriners based in Minneapolis. The members range in age from 30 to 90, thank you very much. Their motto is, we ride so children can walk. They support the Shriners Children's Hospital. They all own their own horse and saddles.
Wow.
The horses are Sorrel geldings, between 15 and 16 hands high. The team is led by Captain Dennis Myron. Their headquarters are on 93 acres in Maple Plain. Oh man, look at those beautiful horses. They've been in parades all over Minnesota and from Canada to Mexico, including being in the Pasadena Tournament of Roses Parade twice. Thank you very much.
And of course, we always know what follows horses, right?
Hooray!
Thank you for the crew that cleans up after them.
There's the poop parade. Yay!
Absolutely. And I think we have coming next is the Little Gym of Edina. Which specializes in non-competitive classes in gymnastics, sports, and dance, and has the best birthday parties in town.
Whoa.
During the summer, they have two camps to choose from, Skill Thrill and a pre-K camp called Kids Quest. The ages run from 4 months to 12 years old. At 4 months, I could barely roll over.
Well, they want you to do it with style, apparently. Or with a kick, I don't know. Gotta like their t-shirts. Those are
happy,
awesome.
Happy. What a good time.
Of course we need sugar. Come on.
Sugar's a good thing.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. Like nerds. Awesome.
Well, we like to participate too, you know.
Next we have Citizens Independent Bank. They offer a full range of financial products and services for all businesses and personal needs. They've been doing this since 1950. They're independently owned, responsive, and committed to our customers and community. Again, Citizens Independent Bank.
And they've got the Parktacular color. So, you know, thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Enjoy the day.
I got a high five and a whole bunch of candy out of that.
See, what more do you need, frankly?
Nothing.
She's got that, the thing.
The hoverboard. Yes,
the hoverboard.
Oh, my gosh. How cool is that?
And she can actually ride on it.
Again, talent and balance. Good for her.
Yeah, that is just so cool.
You don't want to put me on one of those. It would be ugly.
Wow. You wouldn't be on very long. It'd be a short ride.
It would be a short ride right to the ground.
And that was fun.
It really was fun.
And we're done.
And there it is. We'll leave it to the professionals.
Okay, we've got a performer coming here. This is Boogie for Jesus. Woo. Woo. We'll let him go.
I get a good feeling.
Here's a little known fact. I actually lent him that jacket.
Did you really?
I did.
I would forget to take it back if I were you, but that's just me. Oh. Woo. All right, Boogie for Jesus, a dance ministry that tries to create a party atmosphere. I'm thinking they did it. Their founder takes popular music, cleans up the lyrics, and gives the song a great message. BoogieForJesus.com, folks.
Nice.
All right, coming up next here, we've got the Park Tacular Festival is proud to introduce the St. Louis Park Parktacular Ambassadors alumni members.
How many times can you say Parktacular in one sentence?
Parktacular, Parktacular, Parktacular. The group includes past Miss St. Louis Park, former senior ambassadors, young adult and junior ambassadors. Many are still active in the community. Thank you for your service to St. Louis Park community.
Hey. Woo.
Thank you.
I'll tell you what, you guys, my daughter was an ambassador when she was in third grade. She's now 21, so that tells you how long ago it was, and it was a phenomenal experience. If anyone is considering it, it's a wonderful experience. They keep your children safe. They keep your children occupied. It's just a phenomenal experience for
the kids. Not to mention the skills of being able to present yourself, no matter whether you're in third grade or you're 18, 20, just getting out, learning how to talk to people.
And doing an impromptu wave lesson. Come on.
It's very important. It comes with the territory.
Got it. All right, Friends of the Arts.
Okay. Friends of the Arts is a unique nonprofit community organization that connects people and organizations with the arts, share art-related information and resources, and coordinates community art programs.
Oh, shoot. We got
join
behind.
Them this summer for nights of music, food, and fun at Wolf Park Amphitheater. Music starts at 7 p.m. Oh, wow.
Around that. Okay. What is that car?
Oh!
That's the art car, I bet.
You know what? We have the art car.
Oh!
We have the art car.
Okay.
So these are art cars and art bikes. Artists use their car and bikes as their canvas to bring art to you.
Musicbarn.com. Oh, fun.
And that first car, of course, was featuring Smaug. As in the desolation
yes.
of.
Okay. The dragon car.
Indeed.
Okay.
And
the
we also
lipstick
have the music
car.
And then this, what we've got the camera on right now, I really don't know what that is. But it's cool.
Part car, part motorcycle, part. And she's putting on
lipstick
as she's in the car.
Says, fuck her up. Oh, I love it.
And the motorcycle escaped by.
He got by.
On the other side of the lipstick car.
Aww.
Into first place. Here we have a truck. Thunder.
Nice.
Chalkboard race truck.
I love it.
And this looks like a kiddie car.
With a toilet on top. Yes.
perfect.
And it's a fountain. It's a water feature.
Oh, okay.
You never have to look for a restroom.
Love is like a shiny penny.
And June is busting out all over, apparently. Oh, I love it. Awesome.
This one's not quite as arty.
Not as much.
It's
and here
sharp.
We have a white truck.
Okay, we have Stafford Home Service. They've been serving the community for 65 years, and they offer electrical, heating, cooling, audiovisual, and security services to the entire metro area.
Nice. Hey, and our visitors. Oh, if you've been here at any length of time, you know about the Hopkins Raspberry Festival. They are so excited to be here, and we love having them. They love spending time with their Parktacular friends. Their floats portray Raspberry Basket out of the history of the festival, started by businessmen and farmers during the Great Depression to boost the business in Hopkins. They've done a great job. Our junior royalty, Prince Brecken, Princess Maggie, King Jackson, Queen Grace. And they're on the mechanical spinning raspberry. Gotta love it. The senior ambassadors, Diane and Ron, sit in the basket in the front. Princesses Tia and Christine.
And right on their heels are the Girl Scouts from St. Louis Park area. These girls sell more cookies, and I've had a lot of them. They have fun learning outdoor skills, exploring science and technology, and serving the community to make the world a better place.
Excellent.
Thank you, Girl Scouts.
Thank you.
All right, I think, let's see.
There's a lot of motorcycles going round and round about half a block down.
Yeah, you know who this group is, the Zura Cycle Corps.
The Zura group, all of them are just so wonderful, and they're so much fun when they're in parades. Oh, here they come.
Here they come.
See, I was going to send you out for another wave lesson. Good thing. You would have gotten
nailed. They'll be right here.
Yeah, you would have gotten nailed. That would not have been a good parade showing. You know, I'm not sure where we are on the rest of the parade route, but from where we are sitting right now, there is the most wonderful breeze. So it is a beautiful day for a parade, that's for sure.
Yeah, we've been really fortunate this year with so many pretty days that you can be outside, you can enjoy the outsides, and dare I say the M word, that we haven't seen many of those mosquitoes.
No kidding.
It's true. It's true. It's nice. Oh, geez, here they come.
Now, the Missouri Cycle Corps has been competing and entertaining crowds across the state and the entire Midwest for 60 years. The cyclists purchase their own cycles and they maintain them at their own cost. Look at them, wow. And they practice year-round the routine to maintain their skills when they perform. Wow.
Here they come, and there they go. All right, we have an opening.
We do.
Well, you know, this might be a really good time to talk about one of our great sponsors, Bridgewater Bank. Bridgewater is a full-service bank dedicated to serving the unique needs of individuals, entrepreneurs in the St. Louis Park area, and also throughout the Twin Cities. They're located on Excelsior Boulevard, and Bridgewater prides itself on unconditional banking. So we want to thank them for all that they've done for Parktacular, as well as what they're doing for our community.
Absolutely. They're easy to find. They're not too far from where we're sitting right now.
There you go. It's a good thing. Well, and all of the businesses in St. Louis Park that promote and that help the city and the organizations like Parktacular, it's just so important to the health and vitality of our community. It really can't be understated. Overstated? Over. And what's
all right,
left?
And next up we have some wonderful candidates. Hey there, we have Sydney and Satine. Sydney, why don't you tell me a little bit about yourself? How old are you and what school do you go to?
I go to Aquila Elementary School and I am 9 years old.
Well, congratulations and good luck to you tonight. And why don't you tell me a little bit about yourself?
All right, I am Santine. I go to the St. Louis Park High School and I am a senior this year.
Woo!
And what's been your favorite part about the parade today, Chase?
Just meeting all kinds of different people and having fun.
That's what it's all about. Well, good luck to you as you run to represent your community. Enjoy the day. Haha, thanks for being here. Thanks for volunteering. And thank you for driving.
Those are two of our longtime ambassador volunteers driving that car. Beautiful.
Right, and coming along right now is the St. Louis Park Lacrosse Association. The Lacrosse Association was formed in 2008. In its first season, the association supported teams for boys ranging from 9 to 18 years old. In 2013, the association was expanded to include girls in grades 3 through 6. And in 2016, the spring season, the association has over 100 kids six teams participating in lacrosse. They practice right next to my house, so I've gotten to know what lacrosse is. Right. I didn't have that when I was a kid.
This
is a really, really interesting thing that we are growing experiences here as well.
I recall when lacrosse first started at the high school, some people might remember when John Headley was the assistant principal and some girls went to him and said, really, come on, can't we start this? And he went, yeah, let's go for it.
Huzzah, it is time for the Minnesota Renaissance Festival.
Well, not literally. But
we're a little late.
Yeah.
Well, hey, King Henry invites one and all to his 16th century European village and 16 stages of live entertainment featuring 250 artisans that fill the marketplace. The festival is 20 miles south of Minneapolis on Highway 169 in Shakopee.
And it's wonderful. Yes,
I will absolutely come visit you. The Fairy Garden, Cinderella.
Friends and enemies.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Wonderful.
Friends and enemies. Thank you.
Oh, we love it. Love it.
So it's open weekends, August 20th through October 2nd, plus Labor Day. RenaissanceFest.com.
They have so many wonderful themes each weekend. They can have an Irish theme. They have an October theme. All sorts of family fun, and again, like I said, they have the fairy garden, they have meeting Cinderella, they have the princess garden, so you can get a real chance to interact with all the characters.
And drumsticks,
yes.
All right, next up, that doesn't look like the fast pitch. We got Maple Grove Ambassadors.
Maple Grove, there we go.
I can read in order. Please welcome the ambassadors, Alex, Grace, and Lauren. On their float, they're calling it the Dream of Maple Grove. You see their logo on the back of the float, Dare to Dream, once it gets past us, encouraging people to always reach for their dreams. Ambassadors invite the third weekend in July for us all to go to Maple Grove.
I think they took your waving class.
I think so. Oh. Beautiful waves. They were at Cambridge last night. Cambridge had their coronation.
Oh, my goodness.
And just like you said, it says Dare to Dream on the back.
Yes, Cambridge. Good to see you.
There you have it. And the camera's panning our crowd here. We've got just an excellent lineup of folks coming out to check out the parade. And there's babies, and there's old kids, and there's some really, really, really little babies. Look at some of those little guys there. They're so much fun.
Having a great time.
We got the Shady Siders and also the Sunny Siders.
The hardcore's on the sunny side of the street.
Absolutely.
Well, that's a good line. We should make a song out of that.
There we go.
Right?
So here comes St. Louis Park Fast Pitch Association, K through 12. And let's see. They are a nonprofit, a volunteer-managed youth sports organization serving girls who live or go to school in St. Louis Park. Girls have an opportunity from kindergarten through high school to participate in regional and competitive softball programs during the summer. Welcome to them.
I like the little guy in the wagon just sitting there. Yeah, dude. I do believe this is Union Congregational.
It is. I recognize my friend down there walking.
Oh, all right. Union is a great community partner. They're located. Can we read the sign? I can't read the sign. Oh, wait. He's blowing a little horn thing. Okay. I know the League of Women Voters has met there. They do a lot for community involvement. They're over across 7, not too far.
On Alabama South.
Yeah.
Exactly. I can't get him to look at me.
Could have done a cartwheel.
Yeah, remember the thing about the hoverboard?
Oh, yeah, good point.
Yeah, I do best just standing vertical.
Okay, custom carriers. Custom carriers. Driving a truck through. Boy, is that a fancy one.
That is. Next, we welcome the Zurich Shrine Band. They've been a part of the Minneapolis Shrine for over 100 years. And so we're going to sit back and enjoy the music.
Church over on the west part of St. Louis Park, and this summer we have two boys going to the Philmont Scout Ranch out in New Mexico, and of course we do Many Point Boy Scout Camp at the end of July.
Well, enjoy the summer, enjoy all that you do. Thank you.
All awesome, right.
More candidates.
The camera was on the car, but there was actually a guy there.
I think we might have seen some AAA folks go through too, just before the Boy Scouts.
Oh, I think we maybe did. Yes.
Yes.
All right. This candidate car is Junior Ambassadors. We've got Kaylee and Julia. Julia attends St. Louis, or Susan Lindgren, excuse me, and Kaylee is in the second grade.
Hi.
Good luck, girls. Have fun.
Very nice.
And the Jugheads.
Oh, the Jugheads. Youth Juggling Company, founded and directed by Paul Arnberg and his wife, Wendy. The Jugheads Youth Juggling Club is based in Edina and features school year clubs, summer camps, and an annual variety show. They have two coaches and 16 student leaders, and get this, 115 members.
Wow.
That's impressive.
Nice.
Amazing.
I took juggling lessons, and so far I'm up to one ball.
Well, but it's good to have goals.
It's good to have
goals.
I mean, after 10 years, you figure that's a decent.
One is good.
Definitely.
One is very good.
Look at them. Wow.
There we go. Nice.
Talent.
See, now,
balance,
I think I could,
rhythm.
I think I could do the whistle.
The whistle? Yeah, we can
I think
handle.
That's the part I could do.
Wow. And walking.
There you go, guys.
Look at this. How many does he have?
Oh, and look at the next float coming
five.
Up.
Ha-ha.
New Brighton.
Oh, yes, we got the New Brighton Stockyard Days. The New Brighton Stockyard Days was established in 1889.
Whoa.
Although they no longer exist. They continue to carry on the history of the New Brighton community. In 1991, the New Brighton celebration was combined with the famous antique car run from New London to New Brighton, Minnesota. The race was patterned after the London to Brighton, England run dating back to 1896. And following right on their heels, we've got Senator Ron Latz for Senate. And I think we might get a on the spot with him. There he is.
There's Senator Latz. There's Cheryl. Are you enjoying the day so far?
Having a great day for a parade. It's just fabulous out here.
Thank you. Hillary. And Peggy Flanagan. There's Peggy Flanagan.
Hello.
And Cheryl Uecham is right behind.
Wonderful.
Enjoy the day.
She's got a four-legged friend that's walking
there's
for
Cheryl.
Her as well.
Are you enjoying the day?
Yes, I am very much so.
Welcome, great we're glad to have you.
Thank you, Cheryl. We got some walkers that are really fast and some walkers that are somewhat less fast.
Right.
So we get to use our skills, you know, in these little lulls to say really witty things.
Witty things.
Or we could actually talk about several of the people who made this possible.
Yeah, I think that
people
would be a good
like
way to go.
The Bridgewater Bank, which we've already talked about. Also, we've got Discover St. Louis Park.
Health Partners, Park Nicollet, for example, which is just down the road here. We've also got the Marriott Minneapolis West, which is actually in St. Louis Park. You may not know that, but it's actually over in the Chouinard area.
It's wonderful.
Nordic Wear. Everyone knows Nordic Wear. They're so easy to spot. And here we have the Park Association of Teachers.
Yes, the St. Louis Park Local Teachers Union, and they're joining us today by other union employees who work at the local SLP schools.
And you don't have to live here very long or even have kids to know that the schools are completely invested. From the very yes. top people all the way down to the helpers who come in and volunteer, invested in our kids.
Nice.
Excellent. Nice crowd. Look at the energy. That's wonderful. All right. I do believe we've got the St. Louis Park Hockey Association up here. If you want your son or daughter to join and play hockey, greatest game on ice, as they say. They can start as young as 4 years old. And I've got it written down here that most kids have been known to sleep in their jerseys. So, all right.
That's dedication.
That's dedication.
You also could get ready quicker.
There you go. Well, with practices and games as early as they are, hey, every minute counts.
There you go.
Woo, thank you.
We gotcha.
I need my goalie glove to catch
to
that
catch
candy.
To catch that tootsie roll.
This truly is the state of hockey.
Yep. Gosh, look at all these kids. And there really are all ages here, too. That's kind of fun.
There are, yes. Lace up some fun.
And of course, you can find out more about this program at www.slphockey.org. Looks like registration is open now.
And we just got a puck thrown at us.
I did.
It wasn't at our head, though, so clearly they haven't been listening and kicking us out here, so that's a good thing.
I would say steel drums.
I do believe.
Yes.
Kind of wondering if they've got Bahama Mamas on there. Do you suppose? Probably not. Probably not. Zura's steel drum band.
Aha. They are actually in their 26th parade season, and they've performed around the state of Minnesota and Upper Midwest to the enjoyment of everyone that hears their Caribbean sound, including us. They play various styles of music from Calypso, Caribbean style of Yellow Bird, and Marianne to the 50s rock and roll, limbo rock, and the 1990s line dance song, the Macarena, that we all know and love so well. Let's take that. See, let's take a listen.
Okay, Northeast Minneapolis, Royal Ambassadors. Oh, that looks fun. All right, it looks, my notes say that we have a lot more people than those three, so we will just read off that their ambassadors' names are Frankie, Lauren, Pamela, Annalyn, and Sophia. Welcome, girls.
You're doing the wave that's called Clear the Table. Because you're elevated so that, you know, this way you can reach the people who are sitting on the curb. So, clear the table. Usually
good
to an eight or four count.
So, there's actually multiple levels of learning how to wave.
Yes, that's in the graduate course.
Okay,
so
I understand.
Yeah. I don't know if you guys have taken that class yet.
I probably need to study a little bit more and practice.
There you go. I don't want
juggling with the one ball. All right, 45 TV has a truck here for us. We already passed them up. They're all the fun on 45. Your favorite shows like Mike and Molly, Two Broke Girls, and Family Guy.
Oh, he's got the wave.
There
he's
you go.
He's got the wave.
Powder Puff Clown Club.
Here we have the powder. It's an all-volunteer Powder Puff Clown Club with a really awesome motorized bathtub.
Yeah.
They're a nonprofit organization founded in 1967, which is a long time ago.
Booyah!
Put a real clown in office. Vote for Booyah!
Good one. Funny. Oh! Woo! We just got squirted by a clown.
That's a surprise. Oh. Well, we have some synchronized swimmers who are doing their routine on land.
Clearly, they saw the boat earlier.
Yes.
Yeah.
Minnesota Aquafins. They are a synchronized swimming team based in St. Louis Park. And they welcome swimmers from grades 1st through 12th.
And those of us long-timers in St. Louis Park know that aquatics in St. Louis Park has been a long time coming around. It's a long tradition going back to Sally Callahan. How's that for an old name for those of you that have been around many, many decades?
And next we have Le Sueur's Giant Celebration.
Oh, we've been to that celebration. It's a wonderful one. It's always the first full weekend in August. This year that would mean August 5th, 6th, and 7th. The celebration is located at Legion Park next to the community center. Music, food, refreshments, games all weekend, and fireworks on Saturday. Would that also be the one with the
clear the table?
Corn?
Oh, I don't know.
There's one down that way that has a corn on the cob feast. It's like amazing.
They have the giant green giant on there.
They do indeed.
Well, see, yeah,
that makes
green
sense.
Giants down there, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Ooh.
Now we have some ninjas.
There we are.
This is World Taekwondo Academy in St. Louis Park. The World Taekwondo Academy has been around since 1969, offering the best real martial arts lessons in the area with head instructor Mr. Lemon. I would want these folks on my side if I ran into them on the street some night.
Do they train for the look?
I think they must.
Yeah. All right, the first 10 minutes of every session is the look. Whoa! Wow.
Nicely done.
We just got a little demonstration here with some swords.
And they were a little close for my comfort. I don't know about you guys.
Half of my mustache is missing now.
Oh, God, got it. It looks good, though.
Thank you.
They cleaned it clearly.
It's a good look.
It was good, yeah.
The kid's got a barber career if the whole karate doesn't work out.
You can find out more about them at WTA4U.com. World Taekwondo Academy.
And I do believe that would be the Timberwolves coming.
We do have the Timberwolves, led by Rookie of the Year Carl Anthony Towns and Andrew Wiggins. And your Wolves are here for an exciting season.
And that would be Crunch up on top of his very own band.
He's throwing the basketball.
Yes.
Woo! Thank you! Woo!
Thank you.
I love it. Look at that.
I thought you were tall. I thought you were taller. I thought you were taller.
Dancer, I thought you were taller in real life, yes. You look taller on TV.
I love it. Kids Own Childcare. They were voted the best childcare center in St. Louis Park for 2015. They've been a part of the community for over 25 years. They're located on Alabama Avenue. Look them up.
And I'm hungry right now because I see the Pizza Luce. They've been serving a pizza as Minnesota's best since 1993. They're known for the innovative and creative pizzas.
They're
with more than
garlic.
50
yes!
fresh
the
toppings.
Best grade favor ever, garlic. Oh. Yes.
Thank you.
Literally garlic.
Literally garlic.
I love
clove
it.
Clove of garlic.
Oh,
hooray,
nice
we got
cold.
Our garlic. We're good.
How about some tattoos, too?
Awesome.
Oh, thank you.
And tattoos.
This is the most unique parade favorite ever.
All right, what do we got? Robbinsdale.
We have Robbinsdale Whizbang Days. Robbinsdale will be celebrating its 68th anniversary, and they celebrate this festival the second weekend in July. Whizbang Days is community-sponsored city celebration, and their royalty, we have Miss Robbinsdale, Lois Castle. We have the princesses, Katie and Darling, and their junior ambassadors, Annika, Robert, and Taylor. Thanks
and
for joining us today.
The first float that actually has everyone here.
Yes,
yeah,
hey there.
And next is Kenwood Gymnastics. They're located on 35th and Beltline. They emphasize fitness and fun. Classes from preschool up to adult.
Wow.
And here's some of the gymnasts.
Holy
from
cow!
Kenwood. The louder you cheer, the better the tricks they'll
Amen.
Do.
Amen.
I am impressed. There were a few head over heels flips there, and no one got hurt. We've got.
Way down there.
Oh, this is good. The force is with me right now, or it will be.
Oh boy.
It will be shortly. I can see it coming.
Fantastic.
Do you feel the force?
I feel the force. There's some kids here that are trying to do the gymnastics thing. Love it. Hopefully they got a little flyer. Oh, yep. Saw one of the is that the rebel forces?
It is.
The white one's the rebel force?
Oh, those are the stormtroopers.
Oh, my goodness. You're going to have to start going to some more movies. Minnesota Force, Star Wars, and other pop. Costumers for a Cause is a nonprofit organization dedicated to coordinating the charity events of local pop culture, costume character groups, and supporting programs those groups deliver. Examples include hospitals, charity fund, raising walks, and working with local children community organizations.
That thing, I don't even know what you call it, but I love it.
It's a stormtrooper.
On wheels. Oh, love it.
So saw a great meme today for those who love Star Wars, a great meme today that had Jango Fett that was being wished a happy Father's Day, and he had all the stormtroopers around him.
Jobs.
I thought that was very clever.
Well, how do you guys get the easy jobs?
May the force be with you.
We got
easy
here
jobs.
Early.
Ooh.
I would say them fighting words, but he looks a little scary.
Wow.
And the lesser known Star Wars characters.
Snow White. Aurora.
Yeah, you know.
Scooby-Doo.
Oh, yeah. Oh my gosh, look at Scrappy.
I think a majority of their group was Star Wars, but they have a number of characters represented in the group.
That guy's got the Scrappy face. That is hysterical.
That's great. The Mystery Machine. Hey, Fred.
There's the Mystery Machine. Oh, I love it.
So the cool breeze is blowing again. That feels refreshing. Thank you to the tent provider who shaded us.
No kidding. All right, so the parade is on from 2 to 6 this afternoon, which is just shortly. The Kidtacular Family Activity, sponsored by Nordic Wear, will be taking place. If you're wanting to look at any of this stuff online, it's partacular.org/kidtacular. Also from 2 to 6, free canoe and kayak rides from Hoygaards. Free pony rides.
Aw, yay!
Thanks to the SLP Community Foundation, which is a wonderful group of people working so hard. Fantasy Coral Petting Zoo, Coral. I think the horses are coral colored. I could be wrong. 2 to 8 p.m. Inflatable water slides, activities, and games. All age attractions for a wet and or a wild time. Swimwear is required for the water slides. There is a $15 unlimited wristband or $2 per ride tickets. And, of course, there's one free ride with the particular button. So make sure you do get the button. Do I have time for one more?
Yeah.
4 p.m. is the Ambassador Junior and Young Adult Coronation in the auditorium. And if you haven't seen that, that's also awfully fun. Awfully fun thing to do.
And next, looks like we have Ann Taylor for State Rep for 46A.
Now, I have to admit, I don't know her, so I'm not sure where she is.
I think that might be...
Is that her?
Her.
We could just pick somebody in the crowd.
Oh, there,
oh, there she is. There she is.
She was hiding from our view.
There's Anne.
There okay. she is.
Hi. Oh, and there's a picture on the truck, so we could have figured it out.
And then we also have Frank Drake for Congressional District 5.
There he is. Okay, we got him pointed out to us. That was helpful.
Yes.
Thank you.
You can always tell because they dress up more.
Yeah, you can see him, the only man in the entire block with the tie. But not this guy.
West and next Volkswagen. We have the Minneapolis Aquatennial Organization. Aquatennial will be celebrating the lakes for the 77th year. Festival founders found that the third week of July has been the best weather on record, and so that's when they host this festival. The Aquatennial Organization exists to inspire young Minnesota women to achieve extraordinary futures by providing professional development opportunities through networking and mentoring. Good to see you again.
So we have Princess Rachel, Senior Queen Kay, and Senior Commodore Steven. And then next up we have Senior Princess Deborah and Senior Vice Commodore Douglas. Hello.
Hey again.
In a very cool car.
Nice girl's car.
It's beautiful.
The gate. That's who we've got here. We're gonna get a quick word from them.
You want to tell me a little bit about your organization?
The Gate Church in St. Louis Park. It's at Minnetonka Boulevard, 169. We're just a bunch of rabble-rousing, spirit-filled people on fire for Jesus.
Amen. Enjoy the day. Thanks for being here. Okay.
Uh-oh, it's time to go to school.
Yep, our
that
final
was a really
final
short summer.
For the, yeah.
I know. Got it. You know, they just get shorter and shorter every year, for crying out loud.
I'll tell ya. Seems like they just got out.
Park transportation. They have been providing safe transportation in St. Louis Park since 1988. And they say to us they love being part of this community and they'll continue to give the best service to families in St. Louis Park.
Hey, hey, hello.
Excellent. And folks, I do believe that wraps up our parade.
Fantastic.
What a wonderful parade Hooray! It was. What a wonderful day it was. Closing off with our police officers.
Without whom we could not make this happen.
And do make sure that you come and join us. Woohoo! Please make sure you come and join us. We have the concert tonight, the Shane Martin Band at the amphitheater. And then there's still events going on tomorrow. We have from 9 to 1, Belgian Waffle Brunch, again with Boy Scout Troop 282. And then Community Faith Service from 10:30 to noon.
The end is here.
All faiths are welcome at the amphitheater, and that will close your weekend. It's been a pleasure, folks.
It's been fun. Beth Johnson.
Paul Carver.
Gina Hughes.
Thank you for joining us.
Have a wonderful weekend. A parktacular weekend.
A parktacular weekend.